As far as Mr. Trump having spoken of his willingness for new negotiations with Iran, and what do we think about whether Washington can be trusted again? Washington was never trusted again in the less developed world and the developing world. The key here is to make sure Washington cannot be trusted by its allies. What the Iranians can do here is drive a wedge between the Europeans and the Americans. This is a great opportunity that Iran hasn't had since President Khatami was in power. And let's not forget that President Khatami's chief nuclear negotiator was none other than President Rouhani, current President Rouhani. There will be absolutely no need further negotiations. You cannot pay for the same real estate twice. Dr. Zarif, Iran's foreign minister, has made this perfectly clear. Besides, Washington's sanctions against Iran is completely an oxymoron. Washington has not had any relationships, economic or political, with Iran in 40 years. What these sanctions mean is Washington arm twisting its allies in Europe. Washington cannot arm twist the Russians and the Chinese. It can only arm twist the three signatories in Europe, UK, France, and Germany. And we have seen strong willingness from Germany to stand up to the Washingtonian hegemonic behavior. So there will be zero negotiations. This is at a point where Iran's economy is hurting very badly. Mr. Trump is going to kick out Iran from doing monetary transactions with the rest of the world. He made that perfectly clear in his threat today. As far as the harshest economic measures will be taken against Iran, we should take him seriously at that. He's trying to use that again, the economic issue, further economic arm twisting, as a way to negotiate or get the Iranians to come to the so-called negotiation table to give away their completely national sovereign right to have a defensive capability, which is the Iranian domestic missile capability. So he's going to use these threats and bullying as a way to get the Iranians to want to negotiate with those three countries in Europe. But what Iran needs to make absolutely clear is that there will be absolutely no further negotiations. Iran needs to make that clear with its three European partners. My estimate is that unfortunately the British and the French cannot be entirely counted on. I think Iran should even drive a wedge between these two countries and Germany, who is willing to settle and to deviate and to have a divergence with Washington. It has already exhibited that through the natural gas or the oil pipeline, the Nord Stream pipeline that will be going from the Russian port city of Vyborg to a northeastern port city in Germany. So we have seen some indications from the Germans that they want to bury the hatches between them and the Russians. Iran falls somewhere in the middle of all this. I hope it doesn't become a casualty to the transatlantic alliance that's been going on for the past at least 80 years, 70 to 80 years. And Iranians need to play their cards very, very carefully. I heard about Iran indicating that it needs to go back to enriching uranium at the industrial level. Certainly, that's Iran's right within the NPT. But I wonder if that would be productive as far as maintaining the JCPOA with five nations now on board. Hopefully, definitely five at least. So, my counsel to the Iranians is that this is a very, very sensitive time. Any little thing can be taken advantage of, including military parades, including perhaps writing messages of not such goodwill towards certain regimes, especially one particular regime in the Eastern Mediterranean. Everything is going to be manipulated and will be used against Iran in this media war. So the Iranians have to be very careful not to give an inch to Mr. Trump and his administration. I cannot say the Western media because several mainstream Western media outlets, which I'm not going to name, were quite vocal in their opposition to what Mr. Trump did today. So this is a very interesting time. They happen to be actually supporting the JCPOA, except this one blowhard conservative, so-called conservative, they're not conservative, blowhard right-wing, I should say, media the channel that is praising Mr. Trump and is taking the side of that particular regime in Eastern Mediterranean. So there will be zero negotiation. There should be any more negotiation. Iran should be present and exhibiting itself from a point of strength, which is going to be quite difficult when you have the currency of Iran losing 50% of its purchasing power. This is quite difficult to implement, but the silver lining that I see in all of this is that the Iranian people are very unified. And this is a wonderful thing. When you implement sanctions, which obviously means Washington is arm twisting its allies, when you implement sanctions, the first one of it has many different purposes, but one of its main purposes is to create a wedge amongst the people in that country. And no matter how much more sanctions Mr. Trump would try to implement through very complicated financial, legal codes and regulations in the world, the Iranian people have seen, even our friends and colleagues on the liberal side, they have seen how Washington cannot be trusted, how Washington openly reneged and violated the spirit and letter of the law, not now, not from this point on, but up to now, since July 14, when JCPOA was signed, throughout these entire 2 years, 3 years, as a matter of fact, even under Mr. Obama, who certified the sanction against the Iranian petroleum industry, which they do every 10 years, Mr. President Bush did in 2006, Mr. Obama activated it again in 2016. So the Iranian people are awake and alert and aware that the system in Washington, not just Mr. Trump, the entire neocon and the neo-lib system cannot be trusted. And in that sense, it's an internal political victory for Iran, which is something I'm very concerned about. My colleagues here are very concerned about the unity of the Iranian people and to be able to endure the storm that is going to come toward Iran in economic terms. There will be no war. I can forecast that you. Israelis will not attack Iran. There will be skirmishes between Israel against Iranian positions in Syria. There could be some skirmishes perhaps between the Iranian Navy and the U.S. Navy in the Persian Gulf, although both navies are quite professional. There could be further escalation of threats from the Saudis. There will not be a war. Iran will not be goaded into a war. This is what Mr. Trump wants, goading Iran into internal strife as well as being goaded to draw first blood.